الحمد لله، الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الأحباب، أيها الأخوات الكريمات، أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا اليوم المبارك يوم الجمعة أن يبارك لي ولكم يا رب العالمين. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يهدينا إلى صراطه المستقيم. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينضر وجوهنا يوم تبيض وجوه ويوم تسود وجوه. اللهم أمين أمين يا رب العالمين. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you can. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in too many ayat in the Holy Quran, He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Oh you who have believed, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, look at those who love the Islam, they have loyalty to the deen of Allah azza wa jal, and those who are denying the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Nahl, I'm explaining, making tafsir of this surah these days, I said, let me share with you these ayat, these verses from this chapter today. Those who used to deny Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the people of Mecca, when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to wait for the tribes to come to visit Mecca to deliver the message of Islam to them. Mecca during that time had four doors. People, they used to enter Mecca through these doors. The kuffar, the brigands, or the infidels of Quraysh, they used to send someone to wait for these people to tell them, don't listen to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad is fake. He creates lies. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ مَاذَا أَنزَلَ رَبُّكُمْ قَالُوا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. When they will, they've been asked, what did Allah send down to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? They said, أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. The tales of the old men. Lies. Fake. Forget about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what they say. In the same time, الصحابة, the mu'mineen, they used to wait outside Mecca, further than Mecca, to they were pretending that they are taking care of the sheep and all of that, like shepherds, just to wait these wufud or these people from the tribes to tell them and to talk highly about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَقِيلَ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا مَاذَا أَنزَلَ رَبُّكُمْ. Those who fear Allah Azza wa Jalla, they've been asked, what did Allah send down to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? قالوا خيرا. Allah sent excellent things. Message, Quran, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خيرا للذين أحسنوا في هذه الدنيا حسنا. وكذوا في حسنا and good, the Muslim, the mu'min will get it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you comfort. Allah will give you rizq, livelihood. Allah will make you happy and contentment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the best. خَيْرًا لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا according to the ayah. The mu'min, he is the one who will get the benefits of everything good he is doing during his life. Whenever you help someone, support someone, you have knowledge, you have power, you have money, and you are using this in the right way, you are helping your community, you are helping people, subhanallah, you're going to get the hasan of the dunya. Happiness. Health, children, subhanAllah, success, comfort, tranquility. Too many people, they are losing this. People now, they live between anxiety and depression and the psychiatrists. Some why? Because they are away from Allah, from the manhaj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Manhaj السماء. قالوا خيرا خيرا للذين أحسنوا سبحان الله في هذه الدنيا حسنة. What about الآخرة؟ ولدار الآخرة خير ولنعم دار المتقين. الآخرة is better than الدنيا. Why? الدنيا مظنونة والآخرة متيقنة. دنيا إيه؟ مظنونة. There is nothing certain in this dunya. And if you compare the na'im, whatever Allah is preparing for the mu'mineen, the muslimin, in Jannah, with the dunya, dunya is nothing. Nothing. How? Dunya مظنونة. Today I am healthy, maybe tomorrow I'm going to be sick. Today I am wealthy, tomorrow maybe I'm going to lose my money, or I'm going to leave my money, I'm going to die. See, فَالدُّنْيَا مَظْنُونَ. Nothing certain here. Subhanallah. That's why those who are arrogant, the people of Mecca, during that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He humiliated them in dunya and akhira. Allah put them down. Subhanallah. إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْتَكْبِرِينَ الْمُسْتَفْعِلِينَ. مَأْشِ الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. لأن المتكبر, only one متكبر, He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in Arabic, the grammar, المستكبر, the one who is claiming something, but he's not a good fit for it. You are مستكبر for what? مستفعل. يعني بيدعي شيء مش not فيه. مش فيه. هذا اللغة العربية. مستكبر. أنت you're متكبر for what? As I said, you're weak. أنت أغيار. أغيار يعني between health and wealth, sickness and too many ups and downs in your life. Why you are متكبر? Why you are arrogant? That's why these people, they used to deal with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم like that. ولدار الآخرة خير. الآخرة is good for you. وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. The beginning of everything is better than the end of it is better than its beginning to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the beginning they denied you, ya Rasulullah. But in the end, Allah make you victorious. He was above all, صلى الله عليه وسلم. And in general, وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. The hereafter is better than this dunya for you, ya Rasulullah. That's why, dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَنِعْمَ دَارُ الْمُتَّقِينَ. دَارُ الْمُتَّقِينَ الْجَنَّةِ نَعِيمٌ غَيْرُ زَائِلٍ for eternity, forever. دَارُ الْمُتَّقِينَ. نعم. What kind of دَارُ الْمُتَّقِينَ? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after that, جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ يَدْخُلُونَهَا تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ لهم ما يشاءون كذلك يجزي الله المتقين. الله أسأل الله مصر الله to make us all among them رب العالمين. دار المتقين جنات عدن. Eden paradise. What is the meaning of عدن in Arabic? Not عدن in Yemen. That's عدن. This is عدن. Silent. الدار silent and مقلقلة. عدن. What is the meaning of عدن? عدن الإقامة. You're gonna reside in it. طيب, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing this Jannah for you to reside in it forever, means what? Everything there is perfect. Maybe somebody gonna say, I need something, maybe I will miss it, I cannot get it. No, never. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Jannah al-Iqama, you're gonna reside there. Means you're gonna reside, means everything is ready for you there. Whatever, لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهِ. Whatever you wish, it's there. Whatever you desire, it's there for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Some ayat, for example, in Surah At-Tawbah, verse 100, number 100, Allah said, تجري تحتها الأنهار. What is the difference between من تحتها and تحتها? In Surah At-Tawbah said, تجري تحتها الأنهار from underneath water flow. طيب. And he said, تجري تحتها means the source of that water is coming from somewhere else. It is not from the Jannah, the same Jannah. And the hadith Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says الجنة الفردوس الأعلى, the highest level in Jannah, the water and everything, the source of the water, the whole entire heavens, it's from الفردوس الأعلى. This is explaining to the Jannah, to the verse number 100 in Surah At-Tawbah. جنات تجري من تحتها, the source of the water is coming from far away. But according to this verse, جنات عدن, إذن جنة, paradise, تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Means the source of the water from this Jannah itself. It's nobody can say, maybe somebody can stop this water like nowadays. Ethiopia, they are making dams and no water for Egypt.
or Turkey, they say they make dams, no water for Syria and Iraq. سبحان الله الفرات فرات فنود نار نوتي نوتي جنة نوتي جنة جنة gonna have your جنة and the source of the water from its جنة itself سبحان الله ف it will be fight for water before the day of judgment people will fight for water and one of the big fitna of the false messiah the water he is the one he's the only one who can handle water during that time you wanna drink water believe in me I'm your God the false messiah will do that gonna be سنين كسنين يوسف drought poverty and he is the only one who can have the control see but this is a fitna big fitna but in Jannah no everything is waiting for you there and Jannah means you have to know you have to differentiate between the masakin the dwellings or the where you're gonna dwell there and the Jannah Jannah means garden أصحاب الجنة سورة نون Garden means basatin, fruits, flowers, trees. This is the meaning of Jannah. And your qasr and mansion and palace, it will be inside this Jannah. This exactly, they have to differentiate between this and that. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا Whatever you desire, it's there. Nowadays, if you're looking for something, you're going to get it, if you can, according to your capability. I'm capable, I have certain amount of money, I have power, this is it. But whatever you get there, according to Allah's capability. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا Whatever you desire, it is there for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. There is a story about that king, Persian king. His daughter was taken as a prisoner of war. And subhanallah, somehow, very poor man from the Muslimin, they give it, this girl to him. And that king, he knew what is his daughter, and he tried to get to give money to this man to get his daughter back. And they asked that man, man, how much money you need to release this girl? He said, 1,000 dinar. 1,000 dinar. And somebody else, after he released her to her father, said, you are stupid. This is the daughter of the king. He asked only for 1,000 dinar. And that Arabi man, He said, Wallahi, I don't know any number except 1,000. If I know something more, I will ask. And this is what Arab people used to know. They did not know something called million, billion, trillion. They did not know this in Arabic grammar or Arabic language, you know. Arabic language, the most, thousand, thousand. If you say, for example, I want to say 1,000,000. They used to say thousand, thousand, alf, alf. But they never say 1,000,000. But this man, he said, if I know something more than that, I will mention it. But I don't know, subhanAllah. So this is his capability. But our capability, whatever you're going to get in Jannah, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ Look at this ayah, subhanAllah. You have to stop when you recite the Quran. Verse number 32, the chapter of the bee, Nahl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the condition of the mu'min during his time of death. Look at this, ya salam. Before that, he was talking about the condition of the kuffar during their time of death. الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ ظَالِمِ أَنفُسِهِمْ Where they were oppressing themselves. It was so harsh, so bad for them when their souls was departing from their bodies. But the mu'mineen, look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ طَيِّبِينَ يَقُولُونَ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ اُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ Those who been, subhanAllah, their soul being taken by الْمَلَائِكَةُ طَيِّبِينَ Well, they are طَيِّبِينَ طَيِّبِينَ means what? They are free from any kind of danas, shirk. They were not mushrikeen. They used to worship Allah alone. And they be purified. Tayyib, something pure. Tayyibin, they have no sin. And subhanAllah, malaika, they will say, Salamun alaykum, during their time of death. First of all, when they see them, during their time of death, they're going to say, Salam to you. Salamun alaykum. Let's stop with the salam now. How many salams the mu'mineen they will receive from the malaika? Number one, during their time of death, like this ayah, Salamun alaykum. Before even they treat their souls and they take their souls, they will say سلام عليكم. طيب
how many angels they will take the soul of the person during his time of death.
طبعا angels, we have the angels of mercy, they're gonna deal with the مؤمنين. The angels of punishment with والعياذ بالله the rebellious and the كافرين.
The angels of mercy, they will say سلام عليكم. Sometimes Allah سبحانه وتعالى said توفته رسولنا.
Our messengers, they take his soul.
Sometimes Allah said قل يتوفاكم ملك الموت.
The angel of death, he's the one, he will take your soul.
And sometimes Allah سبحانه وتعالى said تتوفاهم الملائكة.
According to this ayah, الملائكة, they will take their soul.
And one ayah, Surah Az-Zumar, also Allah سبحانه وتعالى said الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها.
Oh, all which one is taking the soul?
Allah or the ملائكة or the angel of death?
All of them.
All of them. How?
The system is going like that.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the order.
The boss and the one is responsible for taking the souls of people, the angel of death.
His name is not, by the way, his name is not Azrael.
There is no dalil from the Quran and Sunnah.
The angel of death, his name is Azrael.
This is in the books of Torah or Injil, whatever.
We don't care about this.
Let's care about our deen, Quran, whatever we have, the authentic hadith and the Quran.
His name is Malak al-Mawt.
قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِلَ بِكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ.
The angel of death will take the order from Allah. Allah will يتوفى الأنفس.
And the angel of death with each person, when they take his soul, 500 angels.
With each person.
They are dealing with his soul to take his soul out.
The point here is, when the mu'mineen, during their time of death,
الملائكة they will say سلام عليكم.
This is one first time they get the salam, peace upon them.
Very important.
Number time, and then number two, or second time,
الملائكة will say سلام to the مؤمنين when they will enter Jannah. They will wait for them and the doors of Jannah will be open. They will wait for them from far away distance to say سلام to you.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم طيبين.
The same word, very important.
You will never enter Jannah if you are not طيب.
طيب means if you are free from any kind of sin.
You have to be pure. Why? Because the Jannah is pure.
You have to be pure.
This is number one.
ملائكة, when you enter Jannah, they will say سلام عليكم.
Now during your time of death,
سلام عليكم.
Before even they take your soul out.
And before you enter Jannah, they will wait for you outside the doors of Jannah, سلام عليكم.
What is the best and the highest salam you can get in Jannah when you enter?
From Allah.
Surah Yasin, verse number 58.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سلام قولا من رب الرحيم.
Allah جعلني وياكم منهم يا رب العالمين.
You're going to get the third salam from Allah
when you are in Jannah.
Allahu Akbar.
Who's saying salam to you?
Allah.
And salam means what? There is no harm.
When you say to your brother, salamu alaykum,
I will never gonna harm you because say, peace be upon you.
Peace upon you.
This is salam, khalas.
This number three, when you are in Jannah, you get from Allah,
al-Ali al-Kabir, salam.
Salamu qawlam ar-Rahim.
And there is a one salam also, we don't have to miss it.
Do you know, there are people of Jannah and people of hellfire.
There is a third group. They call them the people of the heights.
We have long surah, Surah Al-A'raf, one of the surah Tawal.
Surah Al-A'raf, Al-A'raf, the people of the heights.
These people, they will be in hold
at the day of judgment, waiting for 50,000 years.
Why?
They were not bad, على فكرة. They were good people, but they were negative. للأسف الشديد, like too many of us.
Because of their negativity, they're going to be in hold for 50,000 years, no Jannah, no hellfire.
Until Allah will finish the hisab accountability with everybody.
What's wrong?
We know that.
فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةِ الرَّضِيِّ
وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ نَارٌ حَمِيمٌ.
People either they have good deeds more, they're going to go to Jannah, or less good deeds, more bad deeds, they will go to hellfire.
But the people of Al-A'raf, what's wrong with them? Their hasanat equal to their sayyat.
What?
Their hasana equal to their sayyah. Their good deeds equal to their bad deeds.
لآخر معناته أنهم they were خربانين فعلا.
Do you know why خربانين?
Because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said if you make one deed,
bad deed, it will be one say a sin for you. Allah will never get put extra. And if you ask for forgiveness before 6 hours, Allah will erase it, wipe it out. It will not be written. Just one. If you make one good deed, immediately the angel will put it in your record, and not just one, 10 or 700. Imagine if somebody is hasanat equal to his sayyat, means he never makes sayyat. He's making sayyat a lot. Count it like this way. And these people, because of that, they're going to be involved for 50,000 years until Allah will finish the accountability between people. These people, according to the Quran here, subhanAllah, these people, they will stand above Al-A'raf, that place, and they're going to look to the people of Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَعَلَى الْأَعْرَافِ رِجَالٌ يَعْرِفُونَ كُلًّا بِسِيمَاهُمْ. Al-A'raf verse number 46. And they're going to stand. They are, Al-A'raf means the heights, means like عرف الدين. You know the crown of the roster, the top like this. They're going to see the people of Jannah, they're going to see the people of Hellfire. And they are waiting hold like this. They're going to turn their back to the people of Hell. I don't want to go to Hell. But it's not easy for these people to be in hold for 50,000 years. Now you are standing for 2 hours for the bus here under the sun. You're going to make like this. I want to go home. What about if you stay for 50,000 years? You don't know where you're going to go. It's tough time. It's not easy. They're going to turn their back to the people of Hell, and they're going to talk to the people of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that view in the Quran. وَنَادَوْا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ. Huh? They're going to call the people of Jannah. What? And salamun alaykum. They're going to say salam to them. This is salam number 4 from the people of Al-A'raf. Allah mentioned it in the Quran. And salamun alaykum lam yadkhuluha wa hum yatma'un. They say salam to the people of Jannah. We wish if we are with you right now. Aywa. Subhanallah. See, even during their difficult time, they will never going to miss that salam they're going to say to the people of Jannah. Dear brothers, dear sisters, think about Al-Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, work for Al-Jannah. Because Al-Jannah is prepared for the mu'mineen, for the muslimin. Al-Jannah, you have to work for it. You have to work hard for that. Because your life is very short and one shot. You know, we never, as Brother Ali, he never takes somebody to the grave and he comes the second day. He stayed there. Yes, he stayed there. Your life is very one shot. That's it. Do it. Do something good for your final destination, for your akhirah. Don't waste your time. Allah said to Rasulullah, where Rasulullah was making da'wah, jihad, too many things. Said, فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَلَا فَانْصَبْ. إحنا نصبين. إحنا بحب ننصب. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ. وقف. Stand. Pray. Make more ibadah. This is Rasulullah. If you have little spare time, don't waste it. Stand and pray. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ from your da'wah, from your jihad, from whatever. Huh? فَانْصَبْ. Stand and pray. Don't waste your time. Your time is very important. Has value. That's why Malaika will tell them during their time of death to the mu'mineen, after they say salam to them, ادخلوا الجنة بما كنتم تعملون. Enter Jannah because of what you used to do from khair, good. Salah, Qiyam, Quran, Salat al-Jama'ah, coming to the masjid, helping people, making zikr, making ibadat, fasting, giving sadaqah, all of these ibadat because of what you used to do, enter Jannah today. طب رسول الله said in one hadith, nobody will enter Jannah because of his deeds. Is there any contradiction here? No. There is no contradiction between Allah and the Rasul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. Azza wa Jal, يعني according to the ayah, when he was talking about المنافقين in the chapter of التوبه, وَمَا نَقَبُوا إِلَّا أَغْنَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Allah and Rasuluhu together in the same direction. If Rasulullah says something, we're never going to contradict the Quran. And the Quran will never going to contradict the authentic hadith of Rasulullah. فَنَاهُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ said, no one will enter Jannah by his amal, by rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said in this ayah, ادخلوا الجنة, enter Jannah because of what you used to do. Is there any contradiction? No. I will explain it to you. Now, you're living your life, first 15 years of your life, you're eating, drinking, enjoying. There is no taklif. Allah will never ask you about your salah, about your zakah. You're not mature yet, right? After you became mature, 15 years, you get taklif. What is the taklif? Al-salah, al-sawm, al-ibadah, and all of these ibadah. Taklif, is it, who going to get the benefits of the taklif? ده قرآن، ده سنة، ده دين، ده رمزه في الإسلام. يور الله عز وجل يو، ده مصلحة، ده benefits of what Allah is giving it to you. It's going back to you, it's not to Allah. You will never, if you cut yourself of عبادة and standing in salah, you will never gonna benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is الدار and the نافع. But this is good for you. Allah is putting that system of the deen for you to live good life in this dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He's the one who gives you hidayah. He's the one who guides you to follow this, to come for salah in the masjid, to do ibadat. And Allah said, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. To step, brothers and sisters, into Jannah by the mercy of Allah. Because whatever you are doing, if you put it with just a ni'mah, the ni'mah of your sight, or your hearing, or your kidney, or your heart, or anything ni'mah Allah gave it to you, is nothing. Whatever you do is nothing. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you takleef for your own benefit, to put you in the system of His system in this universe, follow the system of Allah, and to step into Jannah by Allah's mercy, wallahi. By Allah's mercy. He said, anybody saying, La ilaha illallah will enter Jannah. But this is not the point to enter Jannah. It is not the point. The point, where are you in Jannah? Aywa. Where are you? This is according to your currency. What's the currency? Dollars? It's not working there anymore. No dollars in Jannah. No. It's not working anymore. Your currency there, it's your good deeds. More good deeds you have, this is your position. The currency of the dunya, money, dollars. More dollars you have, you're close to the ocean, cars, mansion, enjoy. This is dunya. This is the currency of the dunya. More good deeds you have there, more high level in Jannah going to be. But to step in Jannah, by Allah's mercy. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَخَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Surah Yunus verse 50. Subhanallah. وَخَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Brothers, sisters, whenever you see according to this ayah, verse, you see yourself in masjid, making salah, making zikr, making ibadah, reading Quran, turning your face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not just enough to make ibadah, to worship Allah, no. Important too, not to disobey Allah azza wa jalla. Because all of us, mashallah, we are praying. But sometimes the shaitan blame and you do a lot of haram. There is a munkar too. Al-haram. Be away from al-haram at the same time. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطيئين أن تتوب إلى الله واستغفر. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والولي المؤمنين أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters, الجنة is very close to us and the hellfire too. الجنة أقرب إلى أحدكم من شراك نعله وكذلك النار. That's why work hard. Work hard. Make good deeds as much as you can. At the same time, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to deal with you with His justice or mercy. Allahumma amilna bi rahmatika la bi adlik. Say ameen. Allah, deal with us with your mercy, not with your justice. Because justice one by one, we don't need it. احنا واخر بنين ونص. May Allah have mercy on us, ya Rabbi alameen. Work hard, brothers, inshallah. Make good deeds as much as you can. Guard your salah, read your Quran. Teach your kids, your family. Ask about their salah. Very important, not just you, your kids, your family. Give the benefit to them first and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance for all Muslim ummah, ya Rabbi alameen. Allahumma inni da'ika amin. Allahumma ansur al-Islam wa azzil muslimin. A'li bin fadlik kalimatay al-haq wa al-deen. اللهم عافنا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وأبداننا باحيدا يا رب العالمين. اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اشف مكاننا منا مريضا يا رب. وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ثبتنا وسددنا واهدنا واسترنا واجبرنا يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك يا ربنا من الخير كله عاجله وأجله، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وأجله. اللهم يا رب العالمين اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن تنره حق علينا يا رب. اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربي سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات، يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى ينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وأتموا الصلاة.